Welcome to the world of physics. Today we are going to study the crystal oscillator experiment. Here is the circuit diagram in which we are going to use various components like transistor, then crystal oscillator, then capacitors, then resistors. Connect these components as shown in the circuit diagram. In order to study the frequency response, connect CRO to the CRO's Y plate to the emitter and second input of Y plate to the ground. Now we will see the circuit diagram and experimental arrangement. Okay.
उठ गया चलते नहीं सकते बोल
ओके दिस इज द ट्रांजिस्टर दिस इज द इमिटर दिस इज द बेस एंड दिस इज द कलेक्टर ओके दीज आर द कैपेसिटर्स दीज आर द कैपेसिटर्स दीज आर द रेजिस्टर्स एंड दिस इज द क्रिस्टल ऑसिलेटर एंड दिस इज द क्रिस्टल ऑसिलेटर ओके वी हैव टू गिव सप्लाई within these two terminals we have to give supply within these two terminals this is the dc power supply this is the dc power supply our input y input of cro now y input of cro is given at this capacitor okay and the second terminal is given to the crystal oscillator or ground. We will give the input voltage. Now we will give the DC input voltage of 6 volt. Okay? Then we are getting a sine wave. On CRO. Now we have to measure these observations. Now we have to note down these observations. That is lambda, that is wavelength. Of that wave, we have to measure wavelength of that wave. Then time period, then time per division. Okay, then period of wave, then frequency of oscillator is nothing but the reciprocal of period of wave. Okay, then we will see how to measure these observations. Okay, lambda that is wavelength. Of this wave is nothing but the distance between two successive peaks. That is the distance between two successive peaks. Okay, this wave can be adjusted with position knob. That is, this is vertical movement and this is horizontal movement. Okay, I am measuring 1-2 divisions. Okay, 2.2. Okay. We have measured the wavelength of that wave, that is 2.4 division. For the mistakes, okay, it's 2.2 division. Okay. Then we will measure time per division. Okay. This is the time per division knob. It is, and this is the notch. And time per division knob is at its maximum. Okay. And this is in microsecond. This is 0.1 microsecond. Okay. This is time per division is 0.1 microsecond. Okay. Then microsecond can be written in second as 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6 second. Now we have to calculate the period of wave. The formula for period of wave, that is T is equal to lambda into C. We just have to multiply 2.2 by 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6. What will we get? 0.22 into 10 raised to minus 6. Two into 10 raised to minus 6. okay. Now for the calculation of frequency, we have to take reciprocal of period. That is 1 divided by 0.22 into 10 raised to minus 6. Now 10 raised to minus 6 is in the denominator. If we want to take it into the numerator, we will get 1 divided by 0.22 into 10 raised to plus 6. Whatever quantity in the denominator, suppose we are taking in the numerator, sign of the power becomes opposite. Okay. Now 1 divided by 0.22 is 4.54. 4.54 into 10 raised to 6 hertz. That is the frequency of crystal oscillator. Okay. Then 10 raised to 6 can be written as 4.54 mega hertz. Okay. This is the frequency of crystal oscillator which we have determined through this circuit. Let's compare the frequency. We have used 4.47 megahertz crystal oscillator. And after calculation, we are getting 4.54 megahertz frequency of crystal oscillator. These two frequencies are nearly equal to each other.